Hey everybody, welcome back to Stamping School. Page 163 of the Stampin' Up! Annual Catalog 2021. I'm going to use these Give It a Whirl dies right here. And they're really easy to miss in the catalog. But they're a fun interactive die set that makes those kind of ViewMaster cards. And there's a bundle for it. So if you go to page 57, here's the stamps that go with it. Although I did not get these, I just got the dies because I really didn't have a need for these cute little kids. But I could see how they would make a lot of really fun cards for kids, grandkids, well, even some adults, I suppose. They are cute with the little out of this world space theme. So let me show you some things that I did with it and some tricks to put them together. So these are the dies. It's a huge set. So there's 21 pieces, and you can create all kinds of different windows for it. So for instance, this is the main goal, is to have a window and the little dial here. Okay, so you can make your little view masters. So you've got the main piece right here, and then the dial that cuts out with the hole in the middle, and that's key, and I'll show you why. It's got these cute little arrows to show people what to do, and these are just clouds that are fun. You could also use those for the window also, but for the window part, they all have, all the ones that have these tabs are gonna help with the windows. So you've got rectangles, you've got this fan shape, you've got scallop circles, you've got a heart, so, and then they've got these pieces right here that just leave the little indentations. Let me see if I can get the light just right. There it is. So you can kind of see the little arrows. These could be for a thought bubble, or it could also be to cover up the brad. And then some stars. So there's a lot in here. I love the clouds. I'm just thrilled that I've got these clouds that are stitched with the set too. So this is the basic bones of how it works. You're going to cut out your piece here, and it's stitched all the way around, which is kind of nice. It has a little hole in there, and then this has a hole, so that's going to go through here, okay? But before you do that, you need to cut your window, and this is how it works. This lines up here, and you can put this anywhere you want for your viewfinder window. So you can do the heart, you can do the fan, you can do the circle. And with the circle, you could cut that out, and then you can cut this out, and that would go over it. You know what I mean? So you could have a little scallop circle there. So they've got lots of options. So you cut this out, and it makes your window. And then after your window is cut, like this, ta-da. So then you would stamp this in your three little areas. Now there's little indentations there. Do you see them? Yeah, so you can see where you need to stamp. Once you've got those stamped with whatever you want, then your brad goes in the middle. Ta-da-da-da. And then you've got your rotating little viewfinder. And that's the basic bones of it. There's a few things that I learned to help it work a little bit better. I'll show you a few things that did not work. And you can learn from my mistakes, and then you don't have to do that when you get it. So this was my first one. And it's a little hard to grab right here, so I'm going to show you how to make a little riser for the back of it that kind of helps that out. Also, what I did is I had a hard time seeing these little areas, and so I ended up using a pencil, and I drew little lines here so I could see where to stamp. But the problem with that was, is then when I erased it, now I can see my eraser lines. So I drew too hard. So if you're going to use a pencil, just go very lightly so that when you erase it, you don't see the eraser lines on mine. So that was my first one that I did. For this one, I used the Nothing's Better Than stamp set and the dies that go with it, because I thought Nothing's Better Than, and you can put all the different things in the window, and that's in the annual catalog. So the next one that I did, and I haven't mounted it yet, just so I can kind of show you what I did. I decided, I thought, well, why don't I, instead of trying to line these up and stamp them, why don't I just cut little windows and put those on? And actually, and I wanted to add these little guys, which ended up being way too busy for the paper. If you did this in a solid up here, it might have been better, but it was a little too busy. But that was actually tricky because it got caught on my window So the way that I fix that is I put a little piece of acetate right here. So if you decide to do this and you want to, you know, use the whole thing and put it on a color piece of cardstock like that, you need to either cover this with the acetate or something, or cover this. And to me, it was easier just to cut a piece of 2x3 acetate and glue it down. And that way, when this goes in here, it slides and it doesn't stick. So that was my second try at experimenting with it. So that ended up being a lot more work than I had anticipated, but it does spin great. So, and of course, then I would mount it on the card. Then the third thing I did is I was playing around with this and I thought, well, I don't like a seam anyway. Could we just cover it with ribbon? And that would give that a little bit of lift, and that worked pretty good. So there's a little bit more lift here, but I still needed the lift behind this so that it spins better. And then I thought it might look better space-wise if I could do it horizontally. So I just kept playing around with the different orientations on it to see, you know, what ways could we do it. So the tricky thing with this is that the die cuts this way. So to do this one, I had to actually cut everything in the reverse, which isn't bad, but you just kind of have to think about the patterns. So I was getting closer to what I wanted to do for the card. And this is still good, but it was just a little bit hard still to get this tab. It felt like it needed to either stick out or I needed to raise that up a little bit in the back, in the background there. Okay, so then we come to the final card and I figured out how to raise it up and it moves great. And this ended up being exactly what I wanted. Oh, and this is what I did on the inside, by the way. I used that same little, that Nothing Better Than stamp set. I just did this and that. I can add a little label here and I can write or write with a white pen on the inside over here. So I'm gonna show you how to make this one. Oh, and I'll show you one more idea with it that doesn't involve this guy, but makes a gift card holder. So I cut this out of thick white. If you use the thick white, you can really see those little indentations better as you're working. I know it's kind of hard to see on the video, but it's there. And with these stamps, I wanted to have a little bit of a roundness to them. So for instance, on this one, they're straight. See, and which they look great, they're fine. I mean, really, you could get away with it. It looks great, they all fit. It looks really nice. But on this one, you can see how I rounded those out a little bit. So with the photopolymers, you know, you can move those, which is really nice. So what I did is I just kind of put this down here and let's see if we can see, I don't know if you can see it. All right, but I just made my photopolymers stick and just created the roundness on there, just like that. And then I just sort of held it up to see if they sort of fit right there. In there. So I like that. And then they just go right back to being straight again. So it works out great. I chose all the colors that are in the paper, the Flirty Flamingo and the Jade and the Navy. And I'm just going to stamp this right in the window. And then there's this little bitty bitty little, what is that called? The little sparkle, I suppose. Little teeny little sparkle. I'm just going to do that in the Navy. So that's what I did here. Just kept it really simple because my paper's really busy. So adding all the other images. So kind of, oops, keep that in mind when you're doing this and using a lot of patterns. Okay, here's the tricky part. This is where things got, why do I have to make things more complicated? I don't know, but you don't have to do this. You know, I did it because I really wanted the font on this side because it was so much bigger, and the little pattern here and this down in the middle. You don't have to do that. You can make it whatever you want, but if you want to do exactly this, this is how I did it. So I wanted the dial over on this side instead of this side, which means I have to cut it upside down. So I laid this down and I know that I want this paper cut on the small side here and I want this one on the large side. So I did it like this and I cut them together. And then when you're done, you have another piece, two pieces that you can make for another card, and it will cut both of the designer papers at once. All right, so cutting both of those at once, And I used 4-inch paper by 5 1/4, and it was, I just have like this little bit left, which is nice. So very little waste on that. And then there's a little hole here that cuts on each one. I can't even see that. There it is, that little hole. I'm just gonna cut right there along with the hole because that's how much space I kind of wanted right here. So right along the seam there, I'm just gonna bring this up and cut right there. I'm gonna cut right along the hole right there because I can still see the hole, so I'll know where to line things up. And there's that piece and that piece, and they're gonna line up perfectly. And then you'll still have this for another card, whichever way you wanna use it. See, you can do it. You can do it this way, and you can do it the other, you know, you get the idea. There's all sorts of ways that you can now use this piece for. I had to make it complicated. I find too that it helps to have a piece of white paper right behind it for stability because this is kind of, you know, kind of flimsy. So what you could do also is you could just take your piece of solid cardstock and give it a little more stability that way, and then put your main greeting here or whichever. All right, so I have that mounted on the white right there. I can still see my hole, and this is where you're gonna go and cut wherever you want your window to be. So you're gonna line it up with the hole, and it can be anywhere, okay? So, you know, even if it's over on the left, if you're giving it to a left-handed person or whatever, but I'm gonna put it right down here, and you're gonna line up that hole. I just use a little Post-it flag here to hold that down and then go run it through your die cut machine. And there's our window. Now, like I said, if the seam bothers you, you can add your ribbon or a little piece of paper or something. But I'm going to use one of these brads. These are the brads we have this year. They're black and white squares and little rounds. So I think I'm just going to use a big one. Instead of trying to hide it, I'm going to make it part of the design. Because you can see this little one here. So if you want something a little more tiny and discreet, or if you want it to be part of your design, like I'm gonna try and see how it looks. See if I like it. No, I don't like it. We're gonna do the smaller one. Before we put this together, I'm gonna show you how to do these little words here. So this is from that Love You More Than Chocolate, the die. So it says Love You More Than, and I've got those cut out in thick white cardstock. And I've got my silicone mat, and to me this is just the quickest and easiest way to kind of get the glue on these. I put a little bit of this on my silicone mat. That's that Tombow multi-glue. And a sponge dauber. And I just pick up a little bit of this, get a little glue on there, and then use my tweezers to align it. Now, one thing that's really great is that this designer paper has lines on it. And so I can kind of keep that nice and straight and just follow those lines. Okay. All right, so you get the idea. I'll be back in just a minute after I get these on. All right, I have those on. And when this dries, you can literally just roll it off, or you can take it and wash it off, but I just roll it and get it off of there. Okay, now we're gonna put this together. And what you're gonna need is 2 circles of any kind. This is 1 1/4. It really doesn't matter as long as it's not bigger than your card, which we're just gonna create a little bit of a spacer in between. I am using, for this card, I am using the sheets of dimensionals. They come 6 sheets for $8, and they're about 4 1/4 by 4 1/2 inches, so that you get a lot of them. And all we're gonna need is like a 3/4 inch piece for this card and maybe a little other snippet. We'll see how much we use, but I'm just gonna use like a little inch piece. You probably don't even need that much, but we're gonna put this right in between these two, like this, and then we're gonna punch a hole in it. Punch a hole right through the middle. Right there. And that's going to be that spacer between here. So we're going to put the brad through, put this through, and then the spacer. And that really gives you some room to spin that freely. Now what we need to do is put the rest of the dimensionals on. So you could go through a whole bunch of dimensionals, which is why I really like these strips. Oh, they're not strips, they're sheets. They're sheets of the dimensionals that aren't individual. So this is a 3/4 inch piece. And look how much time you save by doing it this way. Look at that. And then we'll just do another little piece on each corner up here. And then you're done. And it makes it really sturdy also because it's very stable. You've got all of your edges nice and lifted to the same as that. There we go. Just make sure it doesn't touch the wheel at all. That's a little close, isn't it? There we go, in the corner there. And then here's my navy card base. I found that if I cut it down to 4 inches by 5.5, it fit better. So it just needed that, you know, just to give it a nice layer all the way around, it just looked a little bit better. So we smooshed that down. Okay, so see, now you've really got the room to use it with that little spacer up in there. Now these are really tiny, this little die, but it does help to put that little arrow up here. But I think people are gonna know how to do that. I don't know if you have to give them the direction because they're very tiny. You can see that I added it up here, but I think people are gonna figure it out. Here's the other thing that I did using the die. I needed a good wedding card and I wanted to do a gift certificate. So I did that really pretty elegant paper with some copper. And then on the inside, I used that die and I created a little gift card holder with it. So let me show you what that looks like on the back side. So here's my panel right here. And then I just added some dimensional strips here to kind of hold where the card was going to be in place. So I laid the card down and I just sort of built like a little barrier. And if you want, you can do a little tab coming off so they can pull it. Or I did a little loop and I just taped it on. This is an old gift card, but you could do it nicer than that. But it'll just a little repositionable tape back here in the loop just to make sure they have something to grab right there. So I think that's going to be fun for gift card holders too. Well, that's it for me. Thanks for watching. Remember, you can print the recipe and the measurements for everything. The link is below that goes to my blog, and there's a PDF link once you get to my blog on the article for this. And also there's a link for how to get the dies from me. So thanks for subscribing, everybody. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. See it, learn it, stamp it.